This is a video review of OnOne Perfect Resize. The version that I'm using is number 7. This is also part of the Perfect Photo Suite package, also by OnOne. What I'm going to do is have one image on the left side, which is currently called Trees Photoshop, and the one on the right is called Trees Perfect Resize. Currently, both these images are at around 7 inches wide. In order to overemphasize what the software is capable of doing, I'm going to change the width to 36 inches for this left image, which, to point out, is very, very fast. And then I'm going to put that there. And then for perfect resize, we're going to go down to File, Automate, Perfect Resize. When the software comes up, you get a full view of what you're working on. You can also use the magnifying glass to zoom in on any particular area, so you can see in real time what it's going to be doing as you're working on the image. So I'm going to change the width once again to 36 inches. And then I'm going to scroll down a bit. Now I have different control options of general purpose, low res JPEG, portrait, landscape, high detail, and custom. But basically, these are different presets to move around the slider. So if I change this to portrait, it just quickly makes the necessary changes. For this particular image, I'm going to make it 5, I'm going to make it 50, just for an example. You can see how it really overemphasizes the noise that was originally in the image. So I'm going to bring that back down to a landscape, which I find just gives the best overall results. I go down to sharpening. Your sharpening method is Unsharp Mask, High Pass, and Progressive. I played around with the different options. I find them to be fairly irrelevant. It really didn't matter. I could get the same results whichever way that I did it. So I found that the highlights and shadows option also didn't do anything particularly useful. However, the amount of high pass that I put on the image definitely, once again, gives you more detail going on within the image, which in this case is bringing out more of the noise. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to bring it down to 110, because for this tutorial I'm trying to show you what the software is in fact capable of doing. And I'm going to come over here to the other side. Which is something that we're going to be looking at. And the options down here, film grain adds noise to the image. If I raise that up, see? I'm not using film grain in what I'm in my experimentations. I'm not using any tiling or gallery wrap because we're not doing special effects. We're simply trying to sharpen an image. These other effects I would do separately within Photoshop itself. But as most of these programs within the Perfect Photo Suite are standalones, you don't actually need Photoshop to use Perfect Resize. So it does have some extra features that you won't use as a plugin. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make some settings here, and I'm going to make that 5, and then I'm going to process this out, and then we'll take a look at the differences. It does take about 2 minutes on to resize the image of this size, which is about 3 feet wide. So I'm just going to pause it. Now, to make this a fair fight, I'm going to use filter sharpen unsharp mask for the right side, for the left side image. Okay. So now, as you can see, the definition from the left to the right is significant. You can see that that when there's a light and a dark next to each other, it creates a sharper edge than what is available within Photoshop. I've tried to duplicate the action to see it do the same thing, but I can't. I was just doing more damage to the image. Something that you'll notice is that when I manually do it in Photoshop, the end result is an image that is darker than what is seen within the perfect resize. Perfect resize does not fill in the blacks quite as much. Now, one of the benefits of the perfect resize is I can go in here and I have more control than I originally did in Photoshop. So I'm going to overemphasize these edges so that you can really see what the program can do. After changing some settings, you can now see some significant differences where it's creating these harder edges between the lights and the darks, and it's not overemphasizing the noise that's currently in the image. And the reason is that the noise, the color tone within the noise is subtle, which it allows for, as you can see, but it's emphasizing the sharps, the sharp contrast between the dark and the light. So if I go back over here, you can see how it's created this really sharp edge between the contrasts of the dark and the light. Now, keep in mind, this is blowing up an already grainy image to be 3 feet wide, which is certainly impressive. Here's an example where I'm going to make the image size starting with 3.5 inches, and we're going to take this one up to 11 for an 8.5 by 11, which would otherwise be good for a single page in a magazine. And now I'm going to go down to perfect resize once again. And I'm going to put these settings in here of, again, 11 inches wide. I'm going to actually make this one landscape, which I found gave me the best results. And then I'm going to do a high pass. This one was going to be small. I was only going to do a very subtle sharpen on this one. And then I was going to apply. And this one takes about 30 seconds to process. Now, once again, because of the sharp contrast of the light and the dark, it's clearly obvious what it's done to this image, where it's created these very sharp edges as the image became blown up. Here again, you can see with the tower in the background that what it did was it created a sharp definition within that object. Now, what this is a good example of is the way that that you can take a low megapixel camera, 2 megapixel or something from a phone perhaps, who knows, and blow it up to something that's of a size that you can hang up on a wall of an 8.5 by 11. And this last example is also a 3.5 inch, and I'm going to make it 8.5 by 11. It's going to blow it up. And the reason that I chose this image was because of the harsh lines. You can see major pixelization, sharp edges, very, very pixelated edges that are going on in this image. And I want to show you what happens when photo resize, perfect resize gets involved and does something. With not only the lights and the darks, but also with these pre-existing problems of these jagged edges. So once again, I'm just going to go through the motions of the different settings, and I'm going to come up with something and show you how that looks. Now I'm going to go back to the Photoshop image, and I'm going to give it a sharpen unsharp mask. It should be pretty obvious to you what it's doing. It's having a very hard time trying to create these lines without adding the distortion within the image. Isn't that interesting? In this case, I don't think I can actually get a good sharpening out of this. So as you can see, Perfect Resize did an amazing job on this image. You can see down the side of his face. You can see the sharp lines within here. It's done a very, very good job in the sharpening. And this is why I chose this image, to show you what this program really was capable of doing. I worked on this image for quite some time, and I could not duplicate the detail in Photoshop that this program was able to do by itself. So in conclusion, I definitely have to say that Perfect Resize was a much, much better program to do certain types of sharpening than the built-in Photoshop program was. While it wasn't 100% perfect in all cases, primarily the better the image already was, Perfect Resize wasn't able to do any better of a job. However, the worse the image was, Perfect Resize did an amazing job in retaining the details and blowing up these images to sizes that it otherwise should not be blown up to. If you like this video review, please go to www.theartofretouching.com, where we have reviews of other products and video tutorials on how to use Photoshop, as well as other tips and tricks.